St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King, a legacy of domination for 50 years. Go Fish Ontario, it's catching. Hey, welcome back to Xtreme Angler. This week, wouldn't you know it? Sarcastic, eh? Fishing wood, submerged timber. Sometimes it's gonna be trees in the water, stumps, and like I was just fishing a beaver dam. But it's late August and the water's cooling and stuff, but that really has no bearing on these largemouth. They're in positions where they should be. They're in docks, trees, you name it. They're in all the spots we like to fish for largies. That's near structure and cover. But today, it's about submerged timber. It's timber time for big, fat largemouth. I'm hoping I'm gonna get some big ones, but it's all about perseverance and fishing in the moment. Let the fish tell me what they want. But today, I'm gonna use that little Strike King Rage Tail DB Craw. It's a smaller profile, a little 5/16, 3/16 and 1/4 tungsten sinkers. I'm gonna be fishing little pockets, little edges, different things. Wherever there's wood in the water, I'm gonna put this little bait, let it sink, shake it, move it, drag it, whatever it takes to get those fish to hopefully bite it. So let's keep going. Let's find some logs, and you can use the same things you see here today on Xtreme Angler on your favorite body of water and catch those big fat hogs sitting on the wood. Let's go. See, sometimes when I'm fishing, I don't see specific visual cover. And I know that there's trees that have fallen because in some of the little spots I'm fishing and stuff, I see those trees, but I see the trunks up on the shore. But just, you gotta keep your bait wet. Make those pitches ahead of the boat and stuff. Fishing on tapering shorelines like this, you say to yourself, looks like nothing bass will be attracted to. But I guarantee you, if there's one log, one tree, stick, it doesn't matter. If he's aggressive, if he's just chilling, it's an ambush location for him to sit at. Keep your bait wet. I can't tell you how many fish you'll catch as long as this thing is in the water. It's a common sense. You can't catch when it's out of the water, but keep it in between the hot spots. Keep your bait wet, you'll keep catching fish. Mr. Largemouth, there had to be one here. He ain't a big fish, but he's a bass, and KK started his day. Let me just turn the boat a bit. Look how small he is. You know when you get him through the mouth like that, out through the nose, that he's ate it. He wanted it. I don't know if he was chasing another fish out of there, but if that's my biggest of the day, we're in big trouble. He's not, but he's a bass. He starts my day. Ready, fish? Go on. But these largemouth, when you're fishing the wood like this in late August, you just gotta get in your head that sometimes it's gonna be slower. The mornings aren't gonna be really quick. Just keep fishing. Until this boat's on the trailer, I'm doing this. Pitch, 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 pitch. Every piece of wood I see, tree, beaver dam, doesn't matter what it is, on the edges with pads. As long as there's some wood, I'm gonna keep pitching my little Rage DB Craw inside it and wait for it to do what it just did there. Go like this, or go tick. And one time it's gonna be the kind of fish you're used to seeing on this show. So let's keep going, find some more stuff, and hopefully that was a signal that now they want to start biting. Let's go. Boy, it's a good tree. Oh, tapering down from 3 feet down to about 12. Wow. Someday there's gonna be a big fish on that tree. Maybe later today. Your job is to find that peak time when that fish is biting or wants to bite, and it's got logs coming up from the sides too. Son of a gun, that was a potential hot spot, boy. And what I'll do, I'll put a little waypoint to remind me when I'm driving by sometimes, looking up in different spots and stuff, see my sonar, they're linked together. I see the little waypoint just to say, okay, what's there? Look over. If this tree comes in the water more, who knows? I'll know that that thing's there. Wood and stuff. When I make those pitches, it goes out, I hold the rod high. I'm not worried about setting hook right away. I'll reel in that slack line and set. But I'm watching the line going down, settling in that deeper 6, 7, 10 feet of water, then shaking it, then reeling up the slack, and then shaking. Nothing, bring it in, same thing. Cast out, and I can feel, by the rod being high, I'm watching the line go down. Bringing in the slack, when I feel bottom, shake it a bit, I can detect a lot more bites or that spongy weight or the pickups. It's incredible. Even with these really good St. Croix rods, you can't feel that bite up sometimes. It's just, they just eat it. These baits look so real. You know, it's nature, man. These things, little craws like that, little DB craw, when they see it, it's done. Let's keep going. Oh yeah, that's a good one. Come here. That's what I mean, sitting in the wood. Come here. That's a good one. Look how he's got that. You think he wanted to eat that craw? Go on. Fishing all that really good wood going down and stuff like that. Come to a spot, beaver dam. I thought I got messed up. I seen a beaver going in there. I go, oh no. Pitch in, line's moving, whack. First good one of the day. So we'll keep moving. It's about 11 o'clock. Started around 8:30 or so, hitting a different wood. I got a bunch of waypoints to still fish. So hopefully those fish will get a bit bigger, bit fatter, and a bit more active. Let's keep going. And as for rod choice today, 7-4, 7-6, and even 7-11. The longer pitches and stuff, I'm going to stay back. Legend Xtreme, Legend Tournament Bass are the key. 7-4, and I got those, all of it rigged on the same thing. Gamma Edge, 20-pound fluorocarbon. The stuff does not break. It's like fluorocarbon, but it's as strong as braid. You can put it in some of the nastiest stuff, and believe me, you can pull those fish out of some crazy stuff. Because when you're fishing in those logs and those trees and the submerged timber and stuff, those bigger fish will rub against stuff. If you have a subpar line, or you think that maybe the 20 pound is too strong, forget it. Don't even fish that stuff. 20 pound is the way to go. Gamma fluorocarbon edge, for me, I use it because it works. It helps you put those big fish in the boat. Come here. Whoa, whoa. Look at this thing fight, hey? You know why? Because he's big and bad. Oh, where did you get it? He just on the side of the face? Oh, oh no, come here, come here. I can't lift you in, oh, but I can grab you in. That's the ones right there, dudes. When you're fishing beaver dams and stuff, look at the belly on that fish. You think he's eating? Because all kinds of rock bass and nasty stuff go in there, and that's what goes in there too. Big, beautiful, largemouth bass. Look how black their back is. They can hide in that tannic water. They fight like beasts, as you can tell. The wood, don't give up on it, man. Seriously, let's put her in a box. We'll take some pictures. She's got more girth, look at that, seriously, than her length, I bet you. You've been eating good, huh? We'll let you go after, don't worry, big girl. Oh, Lordy. Let's put her in here with her friend. Look at that. Now that's a big, fat bass. But look at that belly. Isn't that impressive? Whew. Let's put her in there. Waypoints, make waypoints. Because you're going up a lake and you're focused on where you're driving. You got to be aware of rocks and all that kind of stuff. People, swimming, boaters. And sometimes you miss those little sticks, small beaver dam. But in this case, it must be a big beaver because it comes all the way out here. And I fished. All of a sudden just feel that familiar sensation. That's all it is. No bite, sensation. whack. You know what happens then? The world turns off. It's just you and that fish. Good line. Thank you, Gemma. And them rods, sensitivity, strong. St. Croix, I tell you, man, they make the best rods on earth. That is their tagline, and you've seen why. You can feel those fish, you hit them, and it's got the strength, so you can put them in the boat, a few pictures, and let them go. I'm feeling a bit better. Morning was slow, but now we're starting to catch, and they're getting big. So let's keep going. Have some fun. Fish the wood. Can it hold two giants like that? I don't know. Oh, but it holds some big logs. No, there is. I'm not kidding it, dude. He's stuck. Watch. I let off a line. I kid you not. Hold on a second. Where is that fish? Did I peg him? Look. There it is. Look at that. Sometimes when it's meant to be, dudes, what you do is you put some slack line so you can get him out. I must have pegged him, that hook, because the beaver dam is so thick, it caught on to something. You couldn't believe it, eh? You grabbed that little bait, you thought, what happened? Got pegged. I'll let you go, huh? Come on. Xtreme Edge, presented by Strike King.
Hi, I'm Luke Essel with Strike King Lure Company, and today I'm going to show you a couple tips, a couple ways that I modify a Strike King KVD Sexy Frog. The first thing that I do is I like to trim the legs just a little bit. So I take these little scissors right here, and I'll take about an inch off. And I'll make one just a little bit shorter than the other one. Now I've got shorter legs, it's less for the fish to grab. When you're fishing matted grass and the wind is really blowing over the mat, the fish can't hear the frog very good. So what I do is two things. I take a Strike King tungsten weight, and then I take a Strike King rattle. I take the weight and I'll slide it right in this hole right here. Push it right down in there. Then I'll take the rattle and I'll do the same. That does two things. The weight helps the frog sit lower into the mat. Plus with the rattle, it's banging against each other, creating more of a noise so the fish can really key on it and come up through that mat and get the frog. On windy days, this is a key to help you get more bites with a sexy frog. Here on Kentucky Lake, there's a typical grass mat, and what I like to look for is the real slimy, cheesy, green grass that's got a real nice slick mat on it. I don't want anything thick underneath. I want the grass to be hollow underneath. It's almost like a grass mat is a canopy. That way the fish can move around and swim around and then can find that frog. So what I'm gonna do is I've got my weight, I've got my rattle, and I'm gonna show you how to throw a sexy frog on top of this mat right now. I like to find a mat that's got a lot of pop, and what that is the bluegill are coming up, eating the little freshwater shrimp and little bugs right underneath the mat. So you wanna listen for those Rice Krispies. That's about what it sounds like, is Rice Krispies. And what I typically do is I work this frog with a very slow cadence, just a constant cadence. I mean, sometimes they want it faster, but normally a slow cadence, because the top of the mat is so thick that they got a key on it. So I'm just working it real slow, right across the mat, pulling about every 6 inches. Well, when I get a big blow up and he misses it, I'll immediately throw back behind the hole where he left, and I'll try to get him to come up and eat the frog. There he is. One thing I do is when you hook one on a frog, you immediately have to move his head, pull his head straight up and get it out of that mat. If the fish comes and goes and buries into that grass, you've got a very poor chance of getting that fish out. So you really got to have a strong rod, real strong braid, 65-pound braid. really pull that fish out of the grass, get him coming to you, because 90% of the time he's hooked just like this one. Fat, healthy fish, nice fish. That's how it works on these grass mats with this wind. The weight, the rattle, the shortened legs, that's how it works. Go to your local tackle store and get you some Strike King KVD Sexy Frogs.
When the water's tea color like this, I want a little bit of metal flake or contrast with a natural tone. And what I mean is I want the fish to see the bait, but again, have some natural tone like the green pumpkin with the orange. We all know crayfish have a lot of orange, especially up north in northern Ontario. So it has that natural hue, but I just want them really to see it. You know, because I'm putting it in locations where those fish are. They're on those logs, they see it. If they're there, they're gonna take a shot at it. But adding a little bit of that natural hue, you know, the green pumpkin, you can't beat it. Summer craw is another good option, but I like it because it has the chartreuse real bright when the water is really dingy or it's really wavy, or if it's got some mud action to it, stuff where you're fishing in front of creeks and stuff, and it has more off color, like a muddy tone. For me, that'd be the choice, a summer craw. And black with blue fleck, you can't go wrong. You know what? Everybody uses black and blue. It still works. The reason why they use it, because it catches, but I like using things with green and sometimes that orangey brown. And last but not least, one of my choices for here would be that watermelon with red and black flake. You can't go wrong. Again, natural green. All bait fish have green in them. You add a little bit of red flake, just adds that maybe that triggering effect. Fish see it, they're gonna eat it. Here's the setup. I got that little DB craw, you know, rage tail, Strike King, and I got it on the 4-odd wide gap. You know, I'm having a lot of bite here. So when a fish bites and that bait pulls down, there's a lot of meat there to grab. You know, those bigger fish have that lip, and it has anything. You know, they're bigger, lips are bigger and stuff. The cartilage, I want it to cut through. But I'll push it up like that, and I'll just slowly take it and just over the hook point like that. Just like that. That's it. So you can put in some nasty stuff. But when you set hook, it's no problem. And I was fishing anywhere between 4 feet to 8 to 10. So I had that 5/16 Strike King tour grade tungsten. And I pegged it with a little bobber stop because I'm not dragging it through sand and grass and that kind of stuff where you want different action of maybe the little sinker, you know, mixing up the sand and things like that. I want this to fall exactly where I pitched it, right along the edge of those logs, the front of the log, in the tree, so I peg it. So wherever I pitch it on a slack line, it just falls straight down into those holes, the deep dark spots those bigger fish live. He ain't a big bass, but he was sitting on a little piece of log there. Oh boy, a little log. I think that's one of the ones that were just kissing my bait, kissing and missing. Go on. Boy, oh boy, on the wood. The only wood that's out here, right there. What's there? Bass. Let's keep going. Stumps and trees, wow. But you can make your pitches, long pitches, Polaroid glasses. You have to see those targets. A little, just a light shadow, that's all it is. Light shadow of brown, that's all. Where's the big fish, dude? A real big one. Oh, here we go. Hang on your horses, friend. Yep, look at this. Oh, what a fighter, eh? Wow, he's on that far wood. Look at him fight, go, go, go. And turn him, and he's coming in the boat. Oh, yes, sir. Whoa, yes. Turn that trolling motor out. Look where he got it. Let me show you. See that? Through the nose there? You know he wanted that little DB craw. And how many trees did I fish? Seriously, 50, 60. That's another good, solid fish with a fat belly. And there's logs all through here. Tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to pull out a little bit. I don't want to spook that little spot. Put them in the box and take some pictures and you know the deal, right? Kiss and release. But for right now, he's going in there and see if he's got a friend along some of these logs right here. Come here, fish. Say hi to your friends in there. Look at you. Look at that. Now, they wanted to say hello to the camera. So far today, you know, I've been fishing since about 8:30, and it's about 2:30 now, and sometimes it's a bit of a drag and stuff, but that's fishing, you know. You want to fish for big fish, it's like hunting big bear or elk or deer, whatever it is. You're not going to get a lot, but you're going to get those big ones. You put the time in, the effort in, and I decided I want to fish those deep logs today, brush piles, overhanging trees, beaver dams. Lost a few and caught some good ones. My day is just about done. The rain stayed away, and preferably when I fish this stuff, I'll be honest, I like when it's sunny. It pushes those fish right to the logs and where they should go. That's what happens when you fish the wood properly with the right baits, like Rage Tail, man. Right there, big, beautiful, largemouth. Ready? Ready? Go on. See you, boy, next time.
Young Steel's Ford Lincoln, Gamma Fishing Lines, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Interstate Batteries, Top Gun Marine, Rockwood LED. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.